Good day everyone, welcome back to aking YouTube channel, and today's video we will solve a problem from calculus under the topic the slope of a curve in polar coordinates now. Okay, but in this video we will use the calculus function na ng calculator na. So lahat ng merong ddx na calculator can solve this problem no easily. Alright. So the problem is find the slope of the curve r equal to cos 2 theta at the point 0, 0. Okay? Kaya guys no, since multiple choice to, actually no, magdepende lang tayo sa answers na provided sa choices. Okay? Kasi ganito 'yan. Yung point na 0, 0 hindi clear sa atin if that is r theta or xy. Okay? So later on, it's check natin guys no kung ano yung tama diyan. Okay? Okay, now paano nga ba mag-solve ng slope ng curve in polar coordinates? Now, remember sa polar coordinates yung ating r is a function of theta. Okay? Yung radius natin na radius sa vector na. And then yung corresponding coordinates ng point na yan, okay, in rectangular coordinates na. So ito, okay, gagawin mo na siyang x and y. Na, para mo ako si x, so just I use the formula r cos theta. Na, if you want to solve for y, just use the formula r sine theta. Okay? Oh guys, na, sa rectangular coordinates kasi, meron tayong rekta na pag-solve ng slope. Na, di ba yung slope ng curve? Sa rectangular coordinates ay just the derivative of y with respect to x evaluated at the point, okay, of tangency or at a given point. Now, yung ating y saka x, a function of r and theta. So, itong dy dx, rewrite mo lang siya, no, ng dy d theta, okay. Kumbaga, derivative with respect to theta parehas, no, dx d theta. And what is y? So that is derivative with respect to theta ng r sine theta. And then yung ating denominator, so derivative with respect to theta ng r cos yan theta. Okay. Okay, so kung ano yung r dyan guys, lalagyan mo lang siya na. Yan. So magiging d theta kung ano r natin. So, a function of theta yan. Okay. Sine theta. Tapos, kung merong given na angle, okay, i-balit mo siya dun sa point na yon, no? Okay. So, theta kung ano man siya, no? Theta sub 1, no? Yan. Over. And d theta. Okay. A function of theta. Cosine theta. Evaluated at a certain angle. So, that is theta sub. Okay? So, ito guys, yung mga theta dyan. Papalitan mo lang si theta ng x. Okay? Now, okay, meron tayong given na r is equal to cos 2 theta. Okay? So, ito yung ating function of theta. Then, meron tayong point na 0, 0. Okay? So, first, i-verify natin guys kung ano yung 0, 0 na yan. No? Okay, if it is in polar or in rectangular coordinates na. Okay, kasi guys, di ba, pag r theta yan, pag naka-degrees kasi, nakalagay naman yung symbol ng degrees. Kung naka-radian, okay, di sinusulat yon. Okay, kaya ang best way to check this problem, okay, this point, is to substitute no, yung ano, yung theta na 0. Okay? So, assumption number 1. No? So, kumbaga yung point na 0, 0. Okay? I-treat muna natin sila as polar. No? Okay? So, ito yung r natin. Ito yung theta. So, we will check if the point 0, 0 in polar coordinates no? Satisfy the given polar curve. No? So, sabihin, evaluate mo lang siya. Theta equal to 0. Now, so cosine and 2 times 0. Okay, so cosine 0, siyempre, 1. Okay, so this 1. So, yung dumaan guys na point is 1, 0 radian. So, yung 0, 0 na polar coordinate. Okay? Hindi siya, guys, mag-pass through sa given na polar curve. Okay? So, in this case, guys, no, we can say that yung point na 0, 0 ay point in rectangular coordinate system. So, this is our x and this is our y. Okay, remember, guys, now when given yung x and y, di ba, yung pagkuha ng r is square root ng x squared plus y squared. So, kung parehas ng 0, guys, ano ibig sabihin yan? 0 squared plus 0 squared. So, meron tayong 0 dyan. So, yung r natin 0. So, ang gagawin mo lang dito, guys, is kukunin mo yung value ng theta when r is 0. Okay? So, when r is 0, yung cosine 2 theta. Okay? Kailan magiging 0 yung cosine? Okay? Yung pag yung angle natin dito is 90 degrees or pi over 2. Okay? So, pi over 2. Ayan. Yung ating 2 theta. Okay? Therefore, yung ating theta dito, guys, is pi over 4. Ayun. So, ngayon sa calculator, okay, pwede mo na siya erekta. Okay, take note, guys, na when using polar coordinates, okay, na yung angle mo naka-radian, dapat naka-radian mode din si ano mo, calculator. Ah. Okay, so shift mode 4. Okay. And derivative natin, d dx na. Okay, unahin ko yung r, so cos 2 theta. So 2x. Then yung sin x. Okay? Close natin. Evaluated at pi over 4. Okay? So, ganun sa ilalim. Pero, sa ilalim, guys, no, cosine na may katabi ng ating cosine 2x. Okay? So, dx. Cosine 2x. Okay? Then, cosine x. And evaluated at chi pi over 4. Okay, so the answer is 1. Okay? Yan. So, I hope nasundan nyo yung aking solution and explanation. If you have questions, so just comment down below. No? So, that's it, guys. No, thank you for watching. See you next time.